Chris Murathy is the founder and CEO of Premier Group Limited. He's the author of three books, namely What Makes You Special, The Shallow End, and The Realities of the 21st Century. He is also a regular contributor in the Daily Nation newspaper. Chris has worked extensively with youth across various sectors, including churches, academic institutions, and corporations, equipping them with relevant knowledge and skills to help them grow amidst the dynamics of the 21st century. As a public speaker, Chris combines a sense of humor, wit, a great stage presence, and a depth of content in addition to his own life experiences. Please welcome Mr. Chris Murathy.
Chris Murathy is my name, and I'm a millennial. There's nothing particularly life-changing about that bit of information, but I thought you should know. Plus, I'm greatly outnumbered here. I feel like it's an auction. Now, the gentleman who gave the keynote address, Ronnie Osumba, is the man who hired me while I was still in college. He came, he saw, he liked, he hired. Such a short recruitment story, huh? Back then, he was still a senior executive at Safaricom Limited before he decided to, you know, try his hand joining the meat eaters, if you know what I mean. And we, the millennials, voted overwhelmingly on Facebook and Twitter. He was winning by a landslide until the material came. He was there. And I was placed in the public sector, corporate sales. And I enjoyed it for a while. I guess I was still wallowing in the euphoria of having been hired into the, you know, most profitable company south of Sahara and north of Limpopo. It was a dream come true. But deep down, I knew that sales wasn't exactly my forte. And how did I know this? I had tried my hand in GNLD, multi-level marketing, while I was still in college. And for 2 years, guess what was my total sales? That's right, zero. I did not even as much as recoup my initial investment. And that's how I knew that maybe, just maybe, I wasn't cut out for sales. The only thing I can sell and sell efficiently is myself. No, not what you're thinking. By that I mean I can charm my way into and out of anything. Especially at traffic offense. That's how I got the job in the first place. But it soon became apparent that maybe I was in the wrong job. I found that my talents were not being utilized. And I told that to everybody who cared to listen and who was in a position to help, especially him. Nonetheless, I took up a volunteer role in another department where I felt that, you know, at least I'm using my talents. You may be wondering, what are your talents? Okay, I have a passion for talking to people. When I was growing up, I thought, you know, the world is dying to hear my opinion, so I was always talking. And I did really well in that department. I can see some of the members who we worked with. Alan Mutugure is over there. He was one of the members of the committee where I was the chairman. Once a chairman, always a chairman. I'm coming for you. Alright. Now, I went to the HR and I told them, you know, guys, I think I'm really good at that, sir. As opposed to what I'm doing now. But you know, our HR system is being run by other group rather than millennials are not exactly what you can call flexible. Therefore, I had to persist doing the same job, but you know, between me and the job, there was no love lost, to be honest. It was just a matter of time before frustration and dissatisfaction kicked in. And I started hating Mondays. Oh, man, Monday morning would come and I'd say, my Lord, why hast thou forsaken me? I would wonder, why on earth is
Monday, so close to Friday. But Friday's so far away from Monday.
It was honestly difficult to wake up in the morning to go to work. Back then I subscribed to the school of thought that, you know, the guy who invented the snooze button should definitely go to heaven. It was my best friend. And while at work, quitting time was at 5 p.m. At 4:30, I would start clearing the desk and saying goodbye to my colleagues and doing all those relationship stuff because I did not want anybody to get in my way as I approached the highlight of my day. At 4:50, I would go to the bathroom. Of course, I had to pee on company dime. At 5, I was gone. He would look around and I was gone. He would wonder, how can a man leave a building so fast? Without a fire drill. In fact, whenever I parked a car, I backpacked so that I can make a speedy exit. At 5, into my car. You know, it's all about I. You know, needless to mention, my performance by this time was heading south expeditiously. You know, but there comes a time, ladies and gentlemen, when a man has to make life-altering decisions, unpleasant as they may be. And I made a tough call to leave this great company, Safari, and my not-so-great job, and pursue my passion. And my talents, and my gifts. And I guess I'm doing well, the fact that I'm standing here today, right? And just to mention, I charge a good amount to do what I used to do for free while I was at Safari. I did a volunteer role. And maybe if the HR was a bit flexible, I would still be there doing it. But again, I am not sure I could have achieved the heights that I have achieved today. So I guess it was a blessing in disguise. Now that he's listening to me, he was honest when he says that he invests in you. He actually does, because I'm a product of his investment. Kwa hali na mali. That's why I voted for him.
More mali than hali.
More mali than hali. That's why I voted. And here is my the millennials. You don't use verb, you see? Because here the generations before. Not millennials. You don't use verb, it's because you know the pros and the cons. It can pay you at any time. I guess that's something that you know. You the HR practitioner as you ought to be, that you can predict these things before they happen. Here's my take. My millennial informed point of view. I think our HR systems are founded upon two fallacious maxims. One, that anyone can do anything. And two, that our greatest areas of improvement are in our weaknesses. And nothing could be farther from the truth. The truth is, we cannot all do anything. We are cut out to do specific things and do them well. It is biological, not prophetic. I recently wrote an article on the National newspaper, like I do regularly. And in it I said, you can train a turkey to climb a tree, but it is more efficient to hire a sparrow. Well, of course, after several trainings and overseas seminars and performance improvement programs, the turkey will eventually climb the tree. But the time it does that, a squirrel has wound down a forest. You know why? Because a squirrel is cut out to climb trees. And there are some things that training will not fix. Because they probably don't need fixing in the past years. I've been taking so many sales training. Consultative account management.
You didn't do anything to my performance? Zero.
Why? Because I was a turkey. Something made you climb a tree. Not everyone can do anything. We are cut out to do specific things. Number two, our greatest areas of improvement is not in our weaknesses. Our greatest areas of improvement and growth is in our strengths. For one simple reason, we are weak in our weaknesses and strong in our strengths. Therefore, HR practitioners, instead of investing so much money training your millennials, trying to fix their weaknesses, channel that money into building your strengths. Ladies and gentlemen, do you want to get the best out of this crop of employees who want what they want? Want it where they want it? Want it how they want it? Want it when they want it? And want it now? In other words, do you want to get the best out of these millennials? Position them properly. Sounds like common sense, right? You'd be amazed at how common sense is not so common. Position them properly. Getting it right in positioning is equally, if not more important than getting it right in recruitment. Messi, the world's finest footballer, would make up a lousy goalkeeper. Is it for lack of talent? I don't think so. It's a question of what? Positioning. Had I been positioned properly, I would probably still be there. But I thank God that He put me where I ought not to have been. And I say, if there's something I learned in the corporate world, it's what I'm going to be doing for the rest of my life. And that is sales. Okay. Position them properly. And right now I have 3 books to show for my work. Right? I manage my time, flexibility. I can be making a deal in the comfort of my bed. While the other fellow is busy working to write my check in and in the office. Why? Because I finally found a place where my talents are recognized. And I am rewarded commensurately to my efforts. Thank you.